Hello students, how are you? Today I am back with my next video for class 7. It is from the book The Buzzword for class 7. As you know children, I have taught you the poem Ozymandias. आप लोगों को याद होगी बच्चों, ये पोएम मैंने आप लोगों को पढ़ाई थी Ozymandias. इस पोएम को मैंने बताया था कि ये एक ऐसे राजा की कहानी है जिसका स्टैचू जो था बनाया गया था और एक रेतीले स्थान पर रखा हुआ था. अब जैसे जैसे टाइम बीतता गया वो उसकी मूर्ति जो थी पुरानी हो गई थी और टूट गई थी. तो ये वो पोएम थी Ozymandias जो मैंने आप लोगों को पढ़ाई थी. अब वो मूर्ति टूट गई है. तो आज मैं इस चैप्टर के आपको क्वेश्चन आंसर्स करवाऊँगी, समरी करवाऊँगी. साथ ही साथ एंड में इस वीडियो के मैं आपको एक अपना पर्सनल नंबर दूंगी जिसमें आपने ये पोएम लर्न करके देनी है, आपने बोलनी है, बोलते हुए शो करनी है. साथ ही साथ आपने ये भी दिखा, आपको ये भी अगर कोई क्वारी है चैप्टर से रिलेटेड, किसी भी मतलब अगर मेरे सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश से रिलेटेड कोई क्वारी है आप लोगों की, सो यू कैन कॉल मी और गिव मी अ मैसेज ऑन माई नंबर. आई एम गिविंग यू माई नंबर, आई एम राइटिंग इट ऑन द टॉप, 7827113064. It is 7827113064. So I am coming directly to the question answers. The first question of the chapter is, where had the traveler come from? Answer to this question is, the traveler had come all over from the Greece or ancient land. Second question, describe the statue of Ozymandias as seen by the traveler. The statue of Ozymandias was the ruins of the stone. It was broken into pieces and face of the statue had scars on it. Third question, near them on the sand half sunk a shattered visage lies. What is meant by a shattered visage? Shattered visage means totally broken, having scars, beauty was gone, and the paint of the face of the statue was off. Nothing beside remains. What does the traveler mean when he says these words? This is the fourth question. Answer to the fourth question is, the poet means that whatever the powers we have or how much powerful we may be, nothing remains forever. One day it has to be ruined. Question number 5. What do the loan and level sand represent? According to the poem here, loan and level sand represent the time when we are alone at the times of ruins. Think and answer B part. First question. The poem on one hand celebrates all the powerful and the mighty forces of nature and time, and on the other hand mocks the pride of human being who thinks they are powerful but are actually insignificant in front of nature. Do you agree with this statement? Give reason for your answer. Answer is, yes, we do agree, as nothing is forever. Our powers and beauty is also for some time. It has to be ruined one day or the other. जैसे हम लोग जानते हैं हर चीज़ जो आई है वो जाएगी, नश्वर है, शरीर भी नश्वर है. इसी प्रकार से जो भी चीज़ आई है वो ज़रूर जाती है. Do you think the poem can be related to the contemporary times and culture? How? Yes, as there was a time when the kings ruled and had different custom, as time changed, the ruler and the customs also changed. So, जैसे जैसे time बीता गया rulers, customers सब change होते गए हैं. तो इसी तरीके से सब कुछ जो है change होता रहता है, कुछ भी हमेशा के लिए नहीं रहता है. Now I am going to read out the summary of this poem. I hope you will write it in your notebooks in neat and clean handwriting. This poem is written by Percy Bysshe Shelley, who was a renowned poet of the Romantic age. This poem tells us about the king Ozymandias and his power of his time. This is a short poem which we call sonnet, which is divided into two stanzas and had only 14 lines. Summary. The narrator meets a traveler of Asian land. The traveler talks about a massive statue which lies shattered in the desert. What remains of the statue are in the two huge legs without an upper body. The shattered face of the statue is partially buried. There is a frown on the face, or the expression is cold. The emotions on the face are realistic. The face made by the sculptor still survives in that barren land. On the pedestal of the statue, it is inscribed by the king. He introduced himself as Ozymandias, the king of kings. The inscription further claims that even the mightiest men will look at the achievement of the king. Now the statue remains in ruins. There is nothing around but the vast stretches of the sand. I hope you are all getting the summary, and you can also see the video. You can just pause it and then write it by making it zoom, and do it in your notebooks and do it very clearly, very neatly, and absolutely correct. Till then, wait for my next video, and bye for now.